Hello guys, welcome to the channel. Today, we will review a movie called Ex Machina. So, spoilers ahead. As the movie starts, we see a man working hard on his computer. Then he receives a message that the CEO of the company has appreciated his hard work and wants him to accompany him for a week. Hearing this, his friends and colleagues get excited. And they begin to congratulate him. The name of this man is Caleb. A helicopter arrives to pick Caleb, as the region where CEO resided was accessible only through helicopter. His house is amid of the forest. And he is living peacefully all alone by himself. Getting off the helicopter, Caleb casts a glance at CEO's house in front of him, which is very splendid. Upon reaching the house, the door asks Caleb for identification. It quickly scans Caleb and hands him an identification card which will help him get access to the house. He meets that company CEO as he enters the house. Arthur, who is the CEO, greets him very happily and talks with respect. Caleb is happy with the welcome that he has received from his boss. He thinks his week will spend joyfully. Arthur starts to show his house to Caleb while talking. Arthur tells Caleb that he can stay in any room he likes, except of one room. That one room is forbidden for Caleb to try to enter. Arthur then takes Caleb to his room, which is white and adorable. Caleb is then handed a contract which is to be signed by him. It's written in the contract that whatever happens inside this house, Caleb isn't allowed to disclose any of it to people outside. Caleb thinks that the contract is really weird and strange. He is scared to sign the contract. Seeing Caleb's expression, Arthur sits down with him and assures that nothing wrong is going to happen to him. Arthur also tells Caleb that if he doesn't want to do this, he is absolutely free to leave, and there is no pressure on him. So Caleb agrees to sign the contract as he wants to work with his CEO. Arthur then tells Caleb that what they are going to make isn't anything ordinary. Arthur plans to make a robot that will look and talk exactly like the humans. In fact, the robot will be so perfect that no one will be able to guess that it is a robot. Hearing this, Caleb gets very excited. He says that this project will be groundbreaking, and with each other's cooperation, they can truly achieve this goal of making a perfect robot. Next day, Caleb is left in a room which has glass walls. The room also had cameras through which the Arthur was going to monitor the conversation between Caleb and the robot. Now a humanoid robot appears in front of Caleb. The robot was designed like a female human being, and had very strong resemblance to real-life humans. The robot's name is Ava, and she begins to converse with Caleb. Caleb feels good when he talks to her. He feels as if he is really talking to a girl. After their conversation, Caleb tells Arthur about the robot. He compliments Arthur about the work he had already done by himself. He tells him that a robot was already human-like. Arthur is happy to hear this. But he also tells Caleb that there is much more work left to be done on her. Caleb moves to his room at night. He is feeling bored as there was nothing for him to do in that room. He was having difficulty falling asleep. He gets up to watch the TV. He turns the TV on, but then he sees a CCTV footage. He changes channels, but all he sees is the different angles of Ava's room. The lights suddenly switch off. Then the red light is turned on. Everything looks mysterious and Caleb is frightened. He tries to unlock the door to get out of the room, but it doesn't open. But the door quickly opens after the lights are back. He goes to Arthur and asks what had happened. Arthur explains that the security of the house was designed in such a way that when lights get turned off, every door in the house get automatically locked. So, that no one could break into the house. Next morning, Caleb sees a girl in his room. She brings him breakfast. Caleb is confused as she is a robot or an actual human being. He then asks Arthur about the girl, who tells him that she was there to help take care of them. Then Caleb asks, "Where is Ava? I need to talk to her." When they meet, Ava shows Caleb a sketch which she had drawn. Caleb asks her, "What have you sketched?" Ava wants Caleb to understand what she had drawn. But Caleb fails to understand anything and tells her to draw something that he could easily understand. Ava agrees and then asks Caleb about his family. Caleb replies that his parents were no more. He doesn't have any friends and he has spent most of his life alone. Ava says okay, and then she turns off the lights of the house to disable the CCTV cameras. She doesn't want Arthur to hear in on their conversation. Ava warns Caleb about Arthur and tells him that Arthur is not a person to be trusted. After warning Caleb, Ava turns the lights back on. Caleb leaves the room and sits with Arthur to get dinner. The lady worker serves food to Arthur, but accidentally drops the wine. Arthur gets mad at her and starts calling her stupid. Caleb clearly doesn't like the way Arthur is treating her. Now, Arthur asks Caleb about the conversation he had with Ava when the lights had gone. Caleb replies, "Nothing special." But Arthur is very clever. He detects that Caleb is surely hiding something from him. Arthur brings Caleb to his lab, where he made the robots. He says that this is where he created Ava, and then shows him a blue brain-like structure. Arthur explains that this was what he used to make the brain for Ava. Caleb looks at it in awe and excitement. Then CEO tells, combining the thoughts of the thousands of people and their facial expression, he was able to make this brain for his robots. So it is very shrewd, sharp and doesn't let you feel that it is a humanoid robot. It is seen in the next scene that Ava comes to Caleb. She expresses to him that she has feelings for him and wants to spend more time with him. Caleb replies, yeah, why not? Now Ava puts on a wig and wears a beautiful dress. Her robotic body is now covered in normal human clothes. She looks exactly like a human. Caleb is also left astonished seeing her. Ava asks him, do you also like me? Do you also think about me? Caleb replies, no. Who told you that? Ava says, don't lie. I can read your mind. I have the power of thinking of thousands of people. I know that you are telling a lie. Caleb gets nervous and accepts that he was lying. Caleb goes to Arthur and says that he had perfectly created the robot. But Caleb believes that Ava is trying to flirt with him. Arthur replies that, since he made her with the thinking ability of thousands of people, it was all normal. She was just reflecting true and normal human behavior. In short, she truly was becoming a human. Then Caleb begins to think that it is a wrong thing to do that. It is not fair. Ava has the same feelings as human beings, and she has been imprisoned in a place. Caleb in his next meetup with Ava explains that human beings and machines are different. Human beings can change their thoughts. They have a great power of imagination and creativity. While machines are confined to think only of what is fitted in their system. Machines do not extend their thoughts from their confined limits in their system. While the human beings create many opportunities for themselves to live a life of freedom. Caleb then asks her, you are just living here. Why do you not ever take any step for yourself? Now, this message gets set in her system. She wants freedom and wants to explore the world outside of this house. She expresses, she also wants to be a free-spirited human being. Next day, Arthur tells Caleb that he wants him to do more tests on Ava. But Caleb feels it is wrong to do any more experiments or tests on Ava. But before he could say anything, Arthur leaves. Ava comes to visit Caleb again. She says that she knows that Caleb came here only to test her. She says that however smart she may be, she will never be a perfect human being. So, what will they do to her if she fails the test? She asks if they will destroy her if she fails to be a human. Caleb says, no. How can I say anything? I know nothing about it. Trust me. Caleb asks her to trust him, and he promises to bring information from Arthur. Caleb tells her that he will do everything in his power to make sure she doesn't get destroyed. Because he knows that she also has feelings like humans and will feel the pain. Ava then turns the lights off. Ava begins to tell Caleb that she likes him. She doesn't want him to leave this place. She asks him not to destroy her if she fails the test. She wants to live with Caleb. Caleb understands that Ava truly has begun to feel like human beings. She also has the wish to live a free life after being released from this place. Next morning, Caleb meets with Arthur. He then asks what will happen to Ava if she fails to get perfect like a human. He asks if he will destroy her. Arthur answers that he will not destroy her, but he will erase all her memory and deactivate her. After that, he will create another brain with more information and technology behind it. Then Caleb thinks Ava is a robot, but she has the understanding and thinking power of thousands of people. She also has emotions. He thinks deactivating and erasing her memory will be like murdering a real human. Caleb decides that he will try to get Ava out of there. He makes Arthur drink excessively and after a while, Arthur loses his consciousness. Taking his identity card, he moves to his room. Caleb then opens Arthur's computer and finds out that there were many robots that had been created before Ava. But they were all deactivated because of having a little fault. He sees that one of the robots was begging to be let out, but Arthur doesn't give her freedom. Caleb thinks that it is murder. Then he sees the lady worker, who tears her skin and shows to Caleb that she too is a robot. That night, Caleb cannot go to sleep. He keeps on thinking about the robots. He gets confused if he too is a robot. He checks his body and even cuts himself to make sure that he is a human. Caleb then makes a plan to release all of the robots from there and give them freedom. Caleb meets Ava and tells her that she was right. She will get destroyed if she fails to pass the tests. But Caleb ensures her that he will help her to get out of there. They make a plan. Caleb will purposely make Arthur drink excessively. And then he will change the security system to open all doors when lights get turned off. All she has to do is turn the lights off when Arthur gets drunk, and then they can leave out of there together. Ava agrees to Caleb's idea. Next day, Caleb goes to Arthur and offers him drink. But to his surprise, Arthur declines to drink. After that, Arthur tells him that Caleb's work here was done. A helicopter will arrive tomorrow to pick him up. Caleb gets worried thinking who will release these robots from here if he has to leave this place. Arthur notices his worried face and tells him about his secret. Arthur plays a video. It is the video of Ava's room. Arthur reveals that even when the lights were off, he could still hear and see the conversation between Caleb and Ava. Arthur knows about the plan Caleb had made the other night. But he isn't angry at all. In fact, Arthur thanks Caleb. Because of Caleb, Ava was truly becoming as close to humans as possible. Arthur also tells Caleb that Ava doesn't love him. She was just trying to use him to get out of there. Ava was just using her brain to survive. Arthur had brought Caleb so that he could see how Ava would use him to get out of there. It was because of the conversations Caleb had with Ava, Arthur's robot was finally working the way he had hoped. Hearing all of this, Caleb gets sad. He feels that he was used by Arthur just to see if Ava would use him to escape. Then the light is gone, which had been switched off by Ava. Then Arthur says, "Oh, she has switched off the lights, just according to your plan. But it is good that you did not alter the system of security." Caleb then reveals that he had already altered the security system yesterday, when Arthur was drunk. Lights come back and Arthur notices that Ava is out of her locked room. Arthur gets mad and punches Caleb, who gets knocked out. Meanwhile, Ava meets the other robot that was used by Arthur. Ava tells her about the plan. Arthur reaches there and orders Ava to go back to her room. She asks Arthur, if she goes back to her room, will he ever let her out? Arthur replies yes. But Ava knows that he is lying. She charges towards Arthur and pins him down. But Arthur is clearly stronger than her. He cuts down one of her hands and starts dragging her. But the other robot puts a knife on Arthur's back. Arthur is hurt and he destroys her. Ava is back on her feet, and she too uses the knife to kill Arthur. Ava moves to another room. She changes her hand from another robot. She puts new layer of skin on her body and puts on a new dress. Ava is completely changed. She was no longer looking like a robot. Caleb wants to get out of there with her. But Ava has locked the door. Caleb begs her to let him out. But Ava doesn't care about him and leaves from there. Ava looked like a human, but she clearly lacked the feeling that weren't fitted on her. She was just focused on the tasks which have been fixed in her system. She lacked of sympathy for humans. Caleb, a human, is now locked inside a room. Ava finally gets out of the house. She is excited to see the world outside of her room. She feels alive. The helicopter arrives to pick up Caleb, but it's Ava who gets on it and leaves from the place. Ava is now among humans and will live a life of a human. But on the other hand, Caleb is stuck in that room because he trusted a robot. Will he ever be able to leave that house like Ava? That is a question we all are left with at the end of the movie. So, what do you guys think of this movie? Could a robot be exactly like a human, and should we humans fear of what kind of robot we are making? Comment down below. And thanks for watching.